Statue of Liberty. Stiffest bitch in the world.
Good morning, Mr. Smith. Have a seat. Make yourself at home.
Who the hell are you? What are you doing
just
here?
Just cool it, baby. Slick Jones, Big Mike's assistant. And I'm here to see you on the matter of some cash.
Look at Mr. Slick. I just spoke to some of your associates downstairs. And this matter's all been straightened up, so I suggest you get out of here right away. Before I have you thrown out of here.
Let's cool it, baby.
By the way, how did you get past the reception desk?
How did you get past the reception desk? I talk soft and carry a big stick.
Beautiful. Oh, wow. Smell it.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm. And you pick that one up. Really beautiful. Thanks.
Sure, baby.
$200,000 gate. Wake up, sleeping beauty. The beast is at your breast.
The Yankees still occupy a firm place in the cellar with no signs of being able to find a new tenant.
Where am I?
Rumor has it that a new manager is warming up
to
the front
office. Turn that bloody thing off. Oh, well. Hi. What year is it? I'm not kidding. I really didn't know where I was.
You're in your room in Johnstown, and this is a nightmare.
Oh. Good morning, nightmare.
Puff?
Ugh, no thanks. What time is it?
8:30. Time to get up?
Helen gone?
Yeah.
Oh.
She just left.
I wanted to say goodbye to her. As soon as I get here, she leaves.
She'll be back. Hey, look, she wants me to show you around town. I have to check into the office this morning, but there's not much to do. I'll be able to take the afternoon off.
Oh, good.
Where'll it be? Statue of Liberty? Empire State Building? The Big A?
The Big A?
Yeah, it's a racetrack.
A racetrack? Who goes there?
All sorts of funny people. You'd love it.
Oh, no. I want to go to Greenwich Village and see the hippies.
There are no more hippies in Greenwich Village, only Long Island teeny boppers. All the real hippies are out in the country, living off the land. I bet you've got more hippies out around Johnstown than we've got here.
Oh, sure. What we have in Johnstown are farmers and fools. They equate hippies with commies. Oh, you've no idea of how bad it was there. That's why I'm here. All my friends have either split for the city or gotten married and settled down to a nice, quiet, comfortable life of nothing. In Johnstown, there are three interesting people, and they're all lunatics.
Blessed are the lunatics.
Yeah, and the hungry. Want some breakfast?
Love so. Go fix breakfast. I'll fix the phone.
Oh, wow, what a stupid thing to do.
Oh, it's all right. I can fix it. You okay?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, damn.
Out. Big Mike Enterprise.
Gino, what's going on?
Yeah, boss.
Where's that black bastard? I've been waiting an hour.
Yeah, okay, yeah, sure, boss.
Look, take a ride over to Smith's office and find out what's happening for me.
I'll get that son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby, I can dig it. With this new job I'm getting, I'm trying to get my money thing together. Things are going to happen for Mr. Slick, baby. Fast. I can feel it.
I know things are going to be great for us. We sure could use some luck. Hey, I'm going to see Madame Fatima tomorrow for a card reading session. Tonight?
Real soon, baby. Maybe we go to the movies.
Yeah.
There's a great double bill playing at the Roosevelt.
Let's go.
Keep your hands off me, fat man. So help me out.
Are you what, pretty boy?
All right, cool it. Both of you. Big Mike wants to see you, Stevens. It's been over 3 weeks since we've had any action from you.
I know. I'm trying to kick the horses. I'm in too much as it is.
Ain't that a coincidence? That's just what Big Mike wants to see you about.
Okay, I just have a business appointment to take care of, and I'll drop by.
Yeah, well, you better make sure you don't skip town. You got that?
Before 8 o'clock tonight.
Don't worry. I'll be there.
Mike is at the Americana Hotel visiting an out-of-town client.
You just tell him that RJ from Texas called. I'm leaving for Marseille in an hour, and I'll contact him next week when I return. I'll have a chance to get acquainted with you.
Well, thank you, sir. I'm looking forward to it. Bye. You scared the devil out of me.
Well, what's your name, baby?
Jennifer Bingham.
Well, Miss Bingham, you never seen a black man before?
Well, yes. No.
Well, my name is Slick Jones. I'm Big Mike's assistant.
Oh, well, then they should call you Big Slick.
Bet, you here?
In the kitchen. Hi. Just finishing the dishes. Want to leave the place spick and span for Helen. You know her. What are you looking at?
You. I never knew a girl in an apron could look so attractive. Hey, I've got a great idea. How'd you like to forget about job hunting for a while and blast off to New England with me?
Oh, I'd love it. I've never been up that way before.
Things aren't too busy in the office right now. I've got some time coming so I can take off. This friend of mine has a little cottage in Truro on the Cape. He says I can use it anytime I want to while he's in Europe. I spent a weekend there once and it's really great.
Oh, Mark, I can't believe it.
Good, look, let's pack a few things. We'll be on the New England Thruway within an hour.
Knock your ass! Look, you black bastard. You blew it this time. I never should have trusted you. You could have made it big, nigger. But you got a shit way to eat. And you, this hot bitch. You ball the first guy that comes along.
I'm really sorry, Mr. Big Mike. Please forgive me. I promise I won't do it again.
Neither will Slick. Leanna, I just fired Jennifer. Send me a new girl right away.
Very well, sir.
Oh, yeah, boss.
Gino.
Yeah, boss.
You and Bear, I want a Monk Mahoney bit right away.
Okay.
Thank you.
I've never known happiness like this. I never even knew it existed. I feel as though happiness is just totally surrounding me. Because of you. It's a new dimension for me.
Been a wonderful thing for me too, Bet. It's all new. As though I'd never done anything before.
I want it to last. To go on like this forever and ever.
Forget it. Come here. Sit. For some time now, more than a year, I've been playing the horses. Oh, Helen never suspected. I did all my homework carefully outside the apartment. No forms or tout sheets left around inadvertently. It was a disease. Sometimes I was lucky, but most of the time I went the way of all chumps. I managed to blow the small nest egg Dad left me. And that's the whole pretty little story. I'm into Big Mike for around 4,000 and he sends his muscle out with an invitation to a conference.
Didn't you go on off of those hoods when you met them on the street?
I guess so. But I couldn't have paid them any easier then than now. Besides, look what we had.
I know. It was beautiful. Oh, Mark, I'm scared. If anything happens to you, I'll die.
Come on, love. You all right?
Darling, look. I have a savings account, more than $500. You could use it. You could use it as a down payment. And Helen makes money, and you work, and you make a good salary, and I'm gonna get a job soon, and we'll all earn the money for you. Well, I'm sure that Mike won't do anything to you if he knows that you're gonna pay him.
Come on, don't cry. I'm a fool. I shouldn't have said anything about it in the first place. There, come on, Bet. There won't be any trouble. Big Mike will make a deal as long as he gets his money.
You're not just saying that.
Well, I'm the one who's saying it, but I also mean it. It's going to be all right. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right.
Once more, I ain't satisfied. Okay, you know the girls and you know the traffic. And you know I know it. So let's get those execs coming in like they should, eh? Or I'm gonna get me a new keeper. Hey, that's tough. Go tell it to your local, Vista representative. Bubbles, let in our guest. Later, baby. I've got company. Mark, baby. Long time no see. How you been?
Well, I just couldn't resist your invitation, Mike.
Oh, I thought you might be busy or something, so I sent Bear and Gino along with a car special.
Let's cut it out, Mike. Can I get something off my chest?
Hey, be my guest.
Thanks.
Who is you?
Bear! Gino! That's better. Our guest just forgot himself for a moment. But he is our guest. Sit down, Mark, baby. What'll it be? Scotch and soda?
Nothing, thanks.
Bubbles. Scotch and soda for Mr. Stevens. Gladys, light him up. I think he likes it filtered. Couldn't reach you last week, Mark. You must have been out of town.
I needed a rest. Took off for Cape Cod.
Hey, Cape Cod, that's wonderful. Everybody should be able to afford a vacation like that. A week in the sun. Tell me something, Mark. Is it very expensive on the Cape?
Look, Mike, I should have been in touch with you. I should have come to see you a week ago, but I'm ready to pay. I can't do it all at once, but I can pay a fourth of it now and the rest of the $3,900 in weekly installments. How about it?
How about what? First of all, my friend, your arithmetic is bad. You don't owe me $3,900.
I don't?
Due to normal interest rates, you owe me $4,500.
Mike, don't be crazy. I'm willing to pay what I owe, but I don't have that kind of money. That's usury.
Hey, usury. I always wondered what that word meant. Do you have a word for this, Mark? From now on, every day, your interest rate goes up $200 a day.
You gotta be kidding.
Don't be upset. I've got my human side, too. This $200 a day will only go for the next 5 days. After that, it stops.
I don't understand.
Well, after that, buddy boy, the entire sum is due. I'll give you a $500 bonus. Then all you have to do is come up with a measly $5,000.
What kind of a man are you, Darcy? I'm a small-time player, but I come to you with a legit proposition, and you give me this shit?
How are you going to get it, Mike, if I don't have it?
Take it out of my hide? Hey, Mike, baby, what kind of an animal are you? You're scared, aren't you? Who are these people? Symbols of your fake superiority? Are they your muscles on one side and your balls on the other? You can't make your own way in this world, can you, Big Mike? You've got to buy it. You're a phony.
Gentlemen, I'm upset. I think our guest has forgotten himself again. Take Mr. Stevens for a little walk in the garden, close to nature.
Did I hurt your feelings, Big Mike? I'm so sorry. I just...
Gino, don't lean too hard on him. My watch said he should be able to walk home.
Gee, Mike, he was pretty fresh.
The jerk didn't even touch his drink, Mike.
Give me it, I'll give it a home.
I was setting him up. I should give you what you gave him.
No, animal. I can still use that muscle of yours. Get up.
Gino, remember the exit we had planned for Mike Mahoney? We'll use it for Stevens.
No, we don't know how it happened. The car's a total wreck. The police seem to think that he might have gone out of control and plunged over the embankment. Thank you, Danny, but there's really nothing you can do. Sure, I'll tell Betty. Keep in touch, huh? Betty, darling, I thought you were asleep.
Hello.
Oh, it's 8:30.
Who's on the phone?
Danny Leonard. The phone has rung constantly.
Mark and I did so many things together. We
right from the start. As soon as you left, we... I just can't begin to describe
darling,
it.
Darling, you're doing fine. Would you like a little drink?
Okay, fine, sure.
As a matter of fact, I think I'll make us both a little drink.
I don't want anything to eat. I just want to tell you about the
How
weekend.
About a little soup and toast, maybe, huh?
No, I don't want anything. Please. Oh, my God. How did they get Mark's car?
They must have found the rental receipt in his wallet. Then they waited until after dark and drove out of the basement garage here. The only chance they might have had to take was that we might see them. And we didn't.
Somehow they're gonna pay for this.
Baby, you don't talk like that. These are professional hoods. They're ruthless, they're animals.
We've got to do something.
Kind of information
about Big Mike Darcy. I want to know his daily routines. I want to know all the people on his staff. And I want to know how he gets all those dirty, crummy jobs done. I've got to know everything. Oh, Helen, darling, will you help me?
Of course I will. You know I will. This thing frightens me so. I think I'll turn in. Suddenly, I'm just knocked out. Forgive me.
In Connecticut. We didn't really win it. A nice little Italian man who had a concession thought we were a nice looking couple. He just gave it to us. I think I'm gonna call him Magellan.
Why, baby?
Because that weekend with Mark was so exciting. It's like taking a voyage around the world.
Darling, I'm very glad you had a lot of fun with Mark. Seems to me that you've developed a little bit of a crush on him.
A crush? Yeah, I guess I did.
Darling, you know, it's going to be awfully rough now. I understand that. But time will heal everything. The most important thing now is that you get some rest. If you can't sleep, call me. I'll be here.
Helen. be all right if I slept in here with you?
You'll be fine there. If you need me, I'm right across the living room.
No, I just don't want to be alone tonight, that's all.
Okay. Come here.
I promise not to snore.
If you do, I'll never forgive you.
Stay out of this neighborhood.
I got a wife and kids, lady. I can't talk about
Big
him.
Big Mike. Very interesting.
You mean no English?
Get out of here, you crazy broad. What do you got, my talking to the sling?
I've been patrolling this beat for 5 years. Let me say this. Big Mike is a gentleman. Connoisseur of the arts. Generous.
Excuse the expression, lady. But confidentially, that guy is a pimp.
You want information? Try the yellow page.
Dangerous.
Try the bar on 73rd Street.
Listen, lady, that guy is trouble.
Lay off, sugar burgers. Lay off. That's big trouble.
Trouble I don't need, lady.
Pero, yo no hablo inglés.
Rat, dirty stick, and no good conniving art. No.
If you're interested in picking up some extra cash,
Don't fool around with him, lady.
What's in it for me?
Hi.
Hi, love.
Boy, do you look tired.
Oh, wow, I am. Totally exhausted. You just wouldn't believe what I've been through today. I've been running all around town trying to find more bookies interested in the downfall of Big Mike Darcy. I've gotten absolutely nowhere. On the one hand, they treat me like a kid, and on the other hand, they're trying to hustle me off to bed with them.
Men certainly will be men, won't they? Why don't you go take a hot bath? Mm.
Sounds good.
Dinner will be ready shortly. Okay, I'll hurry. Hey, I've got news.
Did you get a raise?
No. I just finished the last of my notes on your research project.
Oh, Helen, that's marvelous.
I don't know how marvelous it is, but it certainly took an arm and a leg, 4 weeks, and information from all the 5 boroughs, Chicago, Miami, and Las Vegas.
You know what, Helen? You're wonderful.
While you're soaking, I'll come in and give you a rough review. Well, now for the heart of the mess, other than Big Mike himself. Mike's henchmen are 2 citizens called the Bear and Gino. Nobody even knows their last names, but they do most of Mike's dirty work. And baby.
They're the ones that killed Mark.
And rigged the accident.
Anything else you have to tell me?
There's one gal called Leanna who figures pretty strong. She recruits new talent from Mike's whorehouses. And she's also the bagman. She delivers the dough. Her nickname is the Keeper. She also pimps occasional.
What else do you know about her? What's she like?
She's a very smart dresser, brunette, 5'4", about as sentimental as a dead haddock. Lives East 60s, drives a GTO. She's a lesbian. At present unmarried, swings late, gets up late. After work at 6 o'clock each day, she stops at the Camelot for a couple of Gibsons. Her hobby
is... Wait, that's it. That's the key I needed to the puzzle.
What do you mean?
I'm gonna meet Leanna.
But why?
She's my passport to Big Mike.
Baby, you don't mean that.
It'll work. Don't worry, Helen. Everything's gonna be all right.
Betty, you're scaring me to death. What are you up to?
Before I meet Leanna, there's something else I have to do. I've gotta meet Shuggy.
Okay, Loverlip, hold it. Suck it in. Gorgeous. Let's get just one more, though. Okay, now, same thing. Think sexy thoughts. Marvelous. Betty, sweetie, you look gorgeous. Okay, baby cakes, let's secure. Back on deck at 15.
Long time no see. They kick you out of town and you jump ship, sweetie.
Oh, Sugar, you're a darling. No, nothing like that. I just had to get out of that crazy town before they drove me insane. See, you're still with the same old nautical terms.
Well, you know me, sweetie. I just love the Navy. But those meanies wouldn't let me become a member of the club. Wouldn't you think they could stand one teensy-weensy infiltration?
Oh, you're outrageous. But the perfect prescription for what ails me.
I read about Mark, sweetie. I'm really very sorry.
Thank you.
But, sweetie, come on in and sit a while. Mercy, no, sweetie. They're bad for my deep knee bends.
You're such a fraud, but a dear one.
Now you just stop the snow job and tell Sugie what brings you aboard.
Sugie, I've got a proposition to make.
Well, you know how I love propositions. Lay it on me, sweetie.
Well, I want to learn some judo. Just enough. And in return, I'll pose for you. Clothed, unclothed, anything.
My ESP tells me that's the greatest proposition I'll have today. Sweetie, I accept.
That'll be great.
Sweetie, I'm doing the favor for poor little old Sugie. As a matter of fact, I was wondering what gorgeous, creamy female body I was going to use for a spread that just came through from Freak Out magazine. But why judo? I mean, violence and your delicacy are simply incongruous.
Well, look who's talking.
Touché. Well, we'll go to Central Park. Can you meet me tomorrow afternoon at 5?
Sure. Lovely.
On your face. It's just too much. I can't stand it.
God, give me strength.
Oh, Betty, I'm sorry, really, sweetie. Everybody's going to take pratfalls the first time out.
Look, apologies are going to get you nowhere, you lethal cream puff. Well, I'm not giving up. I've got a lot more bones to break yet.
Oh, a thoroughbred right to the end, huh, sweetie?
Oh, that hurts, too.
It'll be easier next time, sweetie. Now, let's see. We'll shoot the freak-out spread day after tomorrow, my place, 10 o'clock. Then on to lesson number two.
Feeling better?
Oh, I'm aching all over. Here, take a sip.
Would you like one?
Oh, no, thank you. You spoil me enough as it is. You know, I even hate to come home now when I know you're not going to be here.
I know, baby. Now turn over, I'll give you a back rub.
Oh, heaven. Hey, you really do spoil me.
Thank you.
think that just about does it. Well, it looks groovy. Just hope there's enough light that'll register on the film. Mmm. Okay now, Betty, honey. This design is bugging me.
What's with this judo bit? I mean, you really are good.
What's my bag, sweetie? It's Shuggy's thing. Like the lover people say, every cat should scratch his own thing, right?
Okay. But how'd it come to be your bag?
Well, it's the fault of those big brawny males. You should see their faces when I start to defend myself.
I'd love to see.
Since we're playing truth or consequences, how about one for me?
Seems fair.
Well, level with me on this education in the manly arts department.
Would you believe I have to learn how to knock somebody out? I mean, totally O-U-T with absolutely no margin for error.
You mean this isn't a self-defense kick?
No. Strictly offensive.
Well, sweetie, let me set you straight. I mean, you're making the wrong scene.
What do you mean? I mean, I've got all these broken bones for nothing.
Well, you should have told old Shuggy what the gig was. I mean, I thought you wanted to learn a few discouraging moves. Betty, sweetie, anything more complicated than that would take simply months and months. Look, for your size and weight, I'd say this is just about what the doctor ordered.
A blackjack?
Your hip, sweetie, a blackjack. I sometimes keep one in my dark room. There've been an awful lot of burglaries in this building, and I'm not going to be caught unprepared. It's small and quick and gets results.
Let's see.
It's weighted with lead. One sharp blow to the head with that, Betty, my dear, and your would-be plucker is out, and I mean out good. A blackjack makes a dandy dent, but what you really need is a sap. It's wider, and increases your chances of victory by at least 90%. But, you know, the trick is to make sure that the blow lands squarely on the head and not on the shoulder. That could be embarrassing.
Shuggy, one more question.
Fire away.
If a person needed a sharp cutting instrument, what would you suggest for that?
You mean a blade of some sort? Well, honey, I just happen to be a veritable font of information. This, Betty, my love, is an old-fashioned straight razor. Pardon the word straight. I've been using one for years. Increases my sense of living dangerously, don't you know? And kept well honed, it's as sharp a piece of steel as you could find anywhere. Caution is suggested. If something falls to the floor, you can bet it'll be part of your hand.
A straight razor and a blackjack. Magic combination.
Well, I think we've done enough for today. Let's secure.
Motion is carried.
See you at 10 tomorrow.
You mean four bells, matey?
I can't. I can't do anything. Terrible feeling about this.
Please, don't worry. If it's the last thing I want to do, it's upset you.
I don't know if it would be better or worse if I knew what you were going to do.
Maybe I don't even know myself. But I do know one thing. Something has got to be done.
Good evening, Liana.
Hi, Sam.
Put in 2 onions, will you? Let's live it up.
If you can stand it, I'll serve it.
Cheers. Can I get some cigarettes from you?
The machine's right over there, miss.
Hey, Sam, who's the new girl in town?
Never seen her before, but she's quite some chick.
She is.
touch and water, please.
What's your name?
Betty Harrison.
What do you do, Betty?
I do all right, thank you.
Oh, you're the keeper.
Oh? Pretty Betty's been doing some homework.
Cheers.
Why?
Big Mike Darcy.
Yes, but why?
Because I'm putting two brothers through college, thank you.
All right, all right.
Asking questions is part of my job.
And I like to file the answers. I must say, you do seem to have the equipment.
I also know how to drive it.
All right.
Be at this address tomorrow at 5.
All right, get undressed. Are you ready? Tomorrow at 5. Won't be for the evening. Just to get acquainted a bit for an hour or so. Later, if all goes well, you might move around with him. Bahamas, Vegas, Miami. Remember, we have some unfinished business. I have a date with a Gibson. Make sure the door locks behind you. Hmm?
really put you through the ring in these past couple of weeks, haven't I? Don't worry, it's all going to be over very soon. The curtain comes down on the final act the day after tomorrow.
Oh, please don't let my courage fail.
Oh, shush. I've got to rely on you heavily now. I'm to be at Big Mike's at 5 o'clock. So I want you there at 6 o'clock with the car. Keep the engine running.
Oh, dear God.
Oh, don't worry. It just sounds a lot more melodramatic than it really is. It's just that if I have to leave fast, I want to be prepared.
Betty, please change your mind. Mark wouldn't want you to risk your life like this.
We have to do what we have to do. You know what I need?
What?
I need to relax. Get some peace and quiet somewhere. What do you say to you and I taking off tomorrow and going upstate somewhere and just relaxing?
I'd love it.
Good. We can pack a picnic basket, chicken, sandwiches, beer, and just head on up all those back roads.
Sounds like heaven. We can even get a motel room if we get tired.
Great. We're gonna live it up a bit. I have a feeling that the day after tomorrow is going to come all too soon.
Get it, Bubbles.
At once, mistress.
Forget it. I'd go.
Wise-ass brats I don't need.
Come in, bring all that with you. I'll tell Big Mike you're here. She's here. All right.
Hi.
By yourself. You're quite a pretty lady.
Why, thank you. Mind if I smoke?
Go ahead, smoke. Walk across the room and back. Sit down. What do you like to do, you know, to, relax?
I like to read. Dancing. I like to go to the theater.
I like art myself. I've got a few Picassos. Dancing. Why don't you dance for me?
Why not?
And make it something sexy. Thank you.
got that I haven't?
There's a mirror in the can.
I didn't know you were Italian.
Take my lipstick off.
The hell with that.
Look!
Oh!
You could be dancing for him. That's one of his gigs, you know.
Not with that little noise I just heard. Probably bitter. Mike likes that.
Oh, don't remind me. Why does he like to bite so hard?
Oh, don't look at me.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Dumb brat. Hey, let's go take a pee.
How?
Just crack the door open. Come on.
Do we dare?
Sure, they'll never notice.
They're too busy.
What do you think, Liana?
I think you're out of your mind.
Mike really mad? I don't know why I bother with you two pea brains. I suppose the sight of blood really upsets me after 5 o'clock.
Wake up, Mike. You don't even know who I am, do you? Remember Mark? Yeah, Mark Stevens? Yeah, I loved him. And you killed him. Yeah, you killed him. And that's why I killed you.
You know, that reminds me of when that guy Mark was here, Stevens fellow. But
Oh, Mike and I, oh man, did we have a good time. How did it go?
Exactly as I hoped it would.
Good. There you are.
Thanks.
Call me tomorrow and we'll make a date. Okay?
By the way, Big Mike doesn't want to be disturbed for about a half an hour.
All right.
Hey, Betty, I'll walk you to the door.
Sure enough.
It's the first time you've been around here?
Uh-huh.
Hey, what's your name?
You know what my name is. It's Betty.
No, I mean your whole name.
Just call me Betty. That's enough.
Okay.
What's your name?
They call me the Bear.
That's because you're so big and strong.
Oh, I'm not so strong.
Would you like a cigarette?
No, thanks. Yeah, let me do that for you.
Oh.
Let me help you. Oh!
Thank you.
was that lame brain?
For God's sake, relax, man. He's probably out living it up, talking about the weather while the elevator comes.
We got work to do. I'm gonna go talk to Mike.
Wait. He said not to disturb him for half an hour.
This is important.
Boss?
He's probably out for the count.
West Side Highway.
He saw us turn.
Did we lose him?
I think so.
Oh, God, I hope so.
Which one is he?
Oh, that's Gino. He's the smart one.
What does he want with you?
I killed Big Mike.
Baby, no.
And the bear. Betty. Betty, he's there. I see his car.
Thank you.
up in the outside lane. Relax, relax. We're gonna get away. Traffic.